What's good, people? The first thing I do when I wake up in the morning is record a video. Why? Because when I play the game and I'm done playing it, that's all I gotta do. At the time of this voice recording, it is 8:05 a.m. The YouTube grind does not stop. But hopefully, the UKVZ59 grind is gonna come to a stop. People, I know you're probably tired of me using this here weapon, but blame the fact that I'm somewhat of a completionist. Somewhat. I mean, I say somewhat because I'm not gonna sit here and do every single seasonal challenge. I'm not that vested in this game. Plain simple. But anyways, we're on bridges. And I wanna say you all have not seen myself play this map in a hot minute. Speaking of maps not being played in a hot minute, I try to go on to Descent, aka Sheerstein, I believe that's how you say it. But whoa, that's an explosion. That's a mortar strike, actually. Huh. This early in the game? Alright, I already know what kind of match this is going to be. But yeah, I try, but the queue time is so long, so I end up picking another map, and then boom, here we are. So that's why you haven't seen that much Sheerstein, but I'm gonna try to get y'all some gameplay when I get done with this here map. I mean, this here weapon. And y'all saw that, right? That was an alarm trap. This early in the match, someone put out an alarm trap. Oh yeah. See, what had happened was someone was trying to make a house their home, and they messed up and walked right into their own alarm trap. So, good luck trying to stay hidden now, because you just announced your location to the nearest guy to you. And I'm thinking the nearest guy to him would be the guy who would be opening up the container. But still locked. So maybe the person who tripped the alarm trap is the guy who's supposed to be unlocking the container. We won't know. People, I'm going to hush for a very long time, because what you're about to see. Bruh, where do I even start? Well, I'll start from the beginning, I guess. When I went on mute or I stopped talking, I didn't notice the window. But what I did notice was someone moving, and that someone jumped out that window. Again, I didn't notice that window. So it kind of scared me when I heard someone running behind me. He's dead. Now, as for the second guy, I heard him while looting the first guy. Now keep in mind, he had an M249. You heard it shoot at me. And when I was prone on the other, like on the far side of the road, I was trying to aim at him with a UK and puff a headshot. But as we all know, the UK's iron sights is probably like the worst iron sight in the game. What I should have done was grab the first guy's Mosin and then headshot him. Because he was prone and facing me for a good long time, one shot to the head would have killed him. If not stunned him and he would have stood up and tried to run away, then I would have got him. But it's cool it didn't work out like that. And you saw I was running or walking up the road, not the road, the edge of the map, thinking, I'm gonna get him. I'm gonna get him. Wait a minute. He has an M249. He could be prone in some grass, and I will not see him. Let me
The
not.
plane is near. Get ready for the airdrop.
Let me not chase him. So I turned right. And I went to use the comm station thinking, you know, this is an everyday match. But that's when I saw movement near the detector. And I'm assuming that's also when homeboy with an M249 saw movement too. Maybe he was following me after I turned right. I don't know. But the guy who was like in the detector, like dugout, foxhole, whatever you want to call it, I was trying to throw a grenade, bounce it off the detector, and have it land in front of him. But freaking grenade physics in this game wouldn't allow that, so had to waste like what all my resources to get that man. It is what it is. And then that's when a battle with an M249 occurred. Yeah. But let's switch gears, shall we? Let's talk gameplay. So cool, we got three people dead. Even though it didn't feel like three people. Nah, that was definitely three people. What's next? Well, the map? It's pretty quiet. I've killed three people, one of which was the opposite of an ambush. The second guy just, you know, was caught between a rock and a hard place, and the third guy was a legitimate gunfight. So you mean to tell me that I've shot at three people and that's it? Nah, I don't believe that. There has to be someone left. So knowing the comm stations are not available to be used, I run over here, near the airdrop. If you did not hear the sound of a Luger loading for the first time, you would have not heard nor killed that guy. I said it. If you were watching this video and you're thinking, huh, what a jet stop, buy some headphones. The ones I use, you go on to Microsoft.com and order some Xbox, wireless, Bluetooth headphones and put them into your Xbox. Or not put them into it, but link them to your Xbox. And I guarantee you, your experience in this game will be a lot more interesting. Yeah, you thought I was going to say better, wasn't it? No, I have my bad days too. But yeah, if you didn't hear that guy loading his pistol, you would have walked straight by him. And to the untrained eye, to the baby hands that play this game, yes. If the bullet caliber is large enough, you can shoot through certain materials in the game. Matter of fact, there's an elim, as in elimination, where I played with AB21 on Fisk, and y'all know that big yellow barn behind, or like at the back of the map where the island is, where you, if you spawn, you die? Yeah, MG3, my bad, bullets go through that barn, that yellow barn on elimination, like a hot knife through butter. But that's a video, and if you want to find it, you can. I've only played like 3 eliminations on my own channel for like ever. So there's that. But people, there are times when someone spawns up there exactly where I spawned at, and the detector's there, the container's there, and they become a threat within like 5 minutes. Why? Because if you really want to think about it, there's at least 4 different spawn points and or spawn points near that area, and they have nothing to do but to go to that area. Like, there's literally like 1, 2, 3, 4, including the guy, and a 5th on the other side of the river. But like I said, if the container and the detector is up there, what else are they going to do? I'm not saying if you spawn up there, it's a guaranteed threat. Not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, if you spawn up there, oh yeah, you're going to get shot at. Go ahead and prepare for it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Until then, peace.